Stanford University.
The Searsville Dam was built by a private company in 1892, and the dam eventually passed into Stanford ownership, I believe in 1919, and since that time the reservoir has been used for a variety of purposes.
We now understand that the mountains above Searsville are geologically very active in throwing off sediment and now making decisions about how to manage that accumulated sediment, which is 2.7 million cubic yards, is a critical question.
Stanford specialists in law, in history, in water resources, in earth sciences, came together to try to chart a future for Searsville that would be a win-win.
Recognizing that there are important issues with habitat, with rare and endangered species, with flood risks, and with sustainable water supplies. The real challenge is to figure out the best way to address the needs of the full range of stakeholders.
We landed on two different approaches. In the first approach, we'd see the opportunity to create a opening in the bottom of the dam.
This would allow the water to be released along with the sediments and give us the opportunity of recreating a stream bed that would allow the migration of the fish species that live here. It would preserve some of the wetlands, and it would also provide some flood protection for our downstream neighbors.
The second approach assumes that we cannot release this accumulated sediment from behind the dam, and we will need to find a way to stabilize it and keep the dam in place in order to do that. And in that option, we're looking at possible approaches such as a fish ladder or the construction of a fish way. We're very interested in both of these approaches in utilizing what's called adaptive management, which means you basically take it step by step and fairly cautiously to potentially make adjustments and changes based on what you learn as you go along.
Stanford has really tackled this issue from a position as a responsible steward of the environment. The university recognized that it has many of the leading scientists, leading scholars on watershed management issues, and it really capitalized on their knowledge and their commitment to creative solutions. It's a unique experiment. I think it's been fabulously successful.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.